Hi, welcome back to the vlog. I know, I have disappeared for months. I have not been posting any new videos on this channel. I have been crazy busy, I've been getting shoots, and at the same time, I still kept the main channel going. I still posted new videos consistently every week on my main Robin Wong photography channel. I don't have a lot of time for myself, but hey, I'm back now. It is the new year 2024. I hope it's not too late to wish you guys Happy New Year. I do want to keep you guys updated on two significant things that happened to me in the year 2024. Number one, I deactivated my Instagram account. I know, a lot of you are asking, Robin, what were you thinking? Well, I have two Instagram accounts. The first one is my main photography account where I just dump my street photography work. There's plenty of colorful and black and white street photographs there. It's just a place for me to showcase my photographs. I follow zero people. I have zero interactions with anyone. I don't go to anyone's accounts to view the photographs. It's just me there showing my work. The second account is my personal account where I do follow some friends and I do interact with them. We send DMs, I comment on their feed, I comment on their stories. That account was the one that I deactivated. And the reason I deactivated the account was because I realized I spent too much time on social media. Taking a look at the data on Instagram, I was spending about 30 minutes to 45 minutes per day on Instagram, browsing stories, posting, liking posts, commenting, and I think that's really unhealthy. I can't help but wonder if I've spent those 30 minutes to 45 minutes per day doing something else. I could have finished reading some books, and if I spend those 45 minutes running every day for the past 3 to 4 months, I could have lost 10 kilograms of weight. I could have picked up a new skill, right? So me deactivating my Instagram, getting away from everything, is just me reclaiming my life one small step at a time. I think it's been working wonders. It was supposed to be temporary, but I think it's been going on for like almost half a year now, and I think I'm gonna just keep going for a little bit more and see what happens. The second significant thing that happened in the year 2024 was me starting doing live streams. I started live streaming on YouTube about half a year ago. In the beginning, I was struggling. I couldn't figure out how the OBS Studio software works. I have to connect the camera to the computer. I have to set up the microphone. I have to figure out so many things. And when you're going live, a lot of things can go wrong. I won't go into deep details here because I've just written a blog article. Yes, I still keep my blog going and I do intend to update my blog a lot more this year. I'll put a link to the blog article up here talking about my live streaming experience for the past half a year, and it has been very fulfilling. I learned a lot of new things. I think it's a wonderful way for me to interact and connect to my audience. There's direct audience engagement. I know I can't reply to every single comment on YouTube, but me going live every single week, that allows a direct connection between me and my audience, and it allows them to ask me questions directly and I can answer them in real time. I have been enjoying every single session so much, and thank you so much if you are one of those people who tune in every week and say hi. I really appreciate you. My biggest purchase last year, well, not the most expensive, but the one that makes the most difference when it comes to vlogging and making content on YouTube, is this camera that's recording me right now. It's the DJI Osmo Pocket 3. I bought it at a time when it just came out. I was very lucky to secure a unit because now it's sold out everywhere. It is extremely high demand. I don't think I want to do a review on this DJI Pocket 3 because there's like hundreds and thousands of reviews everywhere online already. I don't think I have anything useful to add to any of these reviews, but I do agree with what most people say. It is so convenient. It is perhaps one of the best vlogging solutions out there. So tiny, so compact. It has a powerful gimbal that stabilizes all the footage, and at the same time, it features 1-inch image sensor, allows me to have this very nice, smooth looking video. And if I were to do a little bit in low light, the large image sensor and the bright lens that can handle a little bit of high ISO shooting as well. And the dynamic range is awesome, right? Like, my background is bright and it's not overblown. And yeah, I really appreciate using this DJI Pocket 3. It makes my life a lot easier, especially if I'm doing POV shooting. I haven't posted any new videos from this DJI Pocket 3. I will be posting them very soon on my main channel. I've made several videos. I can't wait to share them with you guys. And this will be my main vlogging camera moving forward. It's just so much easier to carry around and the quality is better. And I didn't even use the external microphone. I didn't buy the Creator Combo. I just got the basic DJI Pocket 3 setup. It's just the camera and this audio is directly from the Pocket 3 itself. And I am now in a restaurant with some friends. Look who I have here. We have Gun.
Hello.
I haven't seen her in a while. We have Jason, who is ordering some awesome food. Yay. And we have Spencer. Say hi to the vlog, Spencer.
Hello.
What are we doing here, Jason?
We are celebrating Robin's birthday.
I think about
a belated one.
Very belated.
Yeah, very belated. And what are we eating?
We are eating Korean barbecue in Sri Padang.
All right, let's cut to the food. Why do you like Korean food?
Meat.
How about you, Gun? Why do you like Korean food?
A lot of side dishes.
Side dishes?
Yes.
Like these, those on the table now. Just finished our dinner and now we're walking toward a place for coffee and dessert. I've never tried this new place. Very excited to eat something sweet. After that, meat and all meat earlier. We are now in this fancy coffee place called, what's it? Coffee 103. Yeah, this is our post-dinner activity, maybe some desserts. They have cakes with liquor. I saw rum and raisin. I think that's gonna be awesome. Okay, the coffee arrived. This moment of truth. Apparently this place has won like multiple international awards or something. So this better be good.
Okay, moment of truth.
It's good. Here comes the cake. What is this cake? Tiramisu.
Yeah.
All right.
Kahlua.
With kahlua, is it?
Yes.
Yeah, and this is rum and raisin with actual rum. Yum. That's all I have for this vlog. I hope you've enjoyed coming along with me, having the Korean barbecue dinner and coffee and some cool desserts. I'll see you guys in the next vlog. Bye-bye.